gentlemen, the church service was over on Sunday at 12 o'clock, so you can move front. Everybody sits in the back pew of the church. It's a lot cooler up front here, too. They got, they took the fans out last night. Oh, well, anyway, if you're comfortable there, you can stay there. Hopefully you can hear us.
How many can speak Pennsylvania Dutch?
One or two, maybe three.
You can play anything you want to.
Yeah. Hey, you know what? This is the 68th year for the festival.
You know, right.
Wow, isn't that fantastic?
It's amazing.
Well, welcome to the Kutztown Folk Festival. We're glad you're here. And also, this is also the year that Jock is married 68 years.
There should be a law against that. 20 years can be.
I don't know. I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think Jackie'd be happy with you. Wait, this guy was out of his shot, okay?
This guy was probably through the town.
We hit a draw on half a Mishkov.
And he was towing a load of manure.
We brought down the Strikesmate Base, which was an institution.
And at the main intersection of town was an old institution.
The got one called the Choker School of Cook.
And there's an old gentleman on a rocking chair.
Yeah, well, Ashraf going on himself. Chup, brought down.
When he seen the farmer, he stepped out in front and said, "You stop right there."
No,
sorry. That's all me and my legs. What do you still
do?
He said to the farmer, "What are you doing?"
"I have the power already been for to move my apple."
The farmer said, "Well, I'm hauling manure to put on my strawberries."
Yeah, so that is just like me deal. He do sugar on mine.
Said, "You know, there's something wrong with you. I put sugar on my strawberries." Well, it looked up on
the Sunday morning
when the Johnny Quapo.
And the church was full.
The bar was closed.
And the pastor was late.
Bar closed in the heart or the body.
And who comes walking in but the devil?
Our doctor in Dunkirk. Hello?
He walked right down the center of the church.
He lied in the same hand. He said, "Now he's near enough, he's fixed enough."
And when the people saw him, they jumped out the windows, ran out the doors.
All except me, my friends.
But all except one woman.
And he was a few, but
exactly, the last few.
Now, I'll prepare my thought. Can't you do me next?
Well, the devil looked at her and he said, "Don't you know who I am?"
"You thought, yeah, you can't be done to me."
She said, "Yes, I do. I know you real well."
"Well, but do me some good, can't you? For what you've been asked for."
"Well, if you know me so well, why is it that you didn't run out?"
"He got my Rudakaya."
"He said, I married your brother."
Yeah. What paper on your chest?
No. That's my name tag.
That is your name tag?
Yep.
Why on your chest?
My mother makes me wear that.
Yeah, on your chest.
Yep. She said every time I go someplace, she never can find me. I don't hear my name. I don't know what my name is. She said, you need to write your name down on a piece of paper somewhere where you look at it once or twice a day.
Oh, you're a pretty regular guy.
Yeah. Hey, you know what I am?
Peg tag.
Is that what that is?
Yeah, that's a peg tag.
I was up here at the antique shop, and they told me this would be a great way to carry a full drink. Put ice in here, and lemonade, and two straws, and you and your partner can have a full drink all day.
How about that? That sounds great.
I didn't like that idea.
You didn't like it?
No. I thought I'd make a planter out of it.
A planter, okay.
You know, like wave petunias?
Yeah.
And then I thought, you know what, that's not right either. I'm going to plant peonies in this.
Peonies?
Yeah, you know, the flower, man. You know. you told me about some sisters you knew.
Schweizmeister had a grossy ranch, Scott.
Two sisters had a big ranch.
They had 850 kids.
They had 150 cows.
Or 10 bulls.
But no bulls.
Four dogs spent a Monday for breakfast on this.
A couple of days later, one of the sisters was eating breakfast.
people went inside come late.
And she was reading the newspaper.
When all the family on the top of the book also, is a thank you when she's in full on the call.
She said, well, look here, tomorrow there's an auction and they're selling bulls.
That was the key.
There I have to go.
So the next morning, free to see her on the auction.
Well, the next morning she got up real early and she went to the auction.
Put me down the paper, but she bull called.
And with her luck, she bought a bull.
Well, now was in hand for him.
But now she's got to get this bull home.
So she now extended for it on the telegraph office.
So she went into town, into the telegraph office.
And I thought to God, he talked to him on the thank you and bull call.
She said, I went down to the sale today and I bought a bull.
When he put my question, why I should get, but they don't go in the truck for the hand for him.
And I need to send my sister a wire that she brings a truck down to pick up this bull.
We feel rich for one month.
Well, she asked, what do you charge per word?
$1 up by $8.
He said $1 per word.
Well, he's not here. Senko in her purse and anxious, but she has all the food.
Well, she went through her purse, went through all her pockets, and sure enough, she found $1.
So he hugged his buddy. Did he look at that?
Well, she thought about this for a little while.
Now, she told me something else to do. You just stay what to do. And so I'm not as comfortable.
She said, I'll tell you what. You put one word on that telegram, and that word is comfortable.
When she raised was new managed.
And she'll understand what you mean.
Now, say, my question is very comfortable. But when she gets raised, he raised as enemy.
Well, you have to understand now, my sister's a little slow. And when she gets the telegram, she's going to read it like this. Come for the bull. You didn't think that was funny? I thought she was a smart woman. She saved money on that telegram. Hey, you know what? Talking about slow people, I got to watch myself. My sister's running around here. My sister, she's slow too. She's unbelievable. She goes to bed at night with a foot ruler to see how long she sleeps.
No kidding.
And she thinks Taco Bell is a Mexican phone company.
Oh my God. I never realized that.
But you know, my mom's proud of me.
Oh, in what way?
Well, you didn't hear.
Hear what?
Well, I'm up here at Kutztown University.
Oh, you went to Kutztown University?
Yes, sir. I'm a student up there.
Well, what are you majoring in?
Psychology.
What year?
This is my third year.
Your third year?
Yeah,
and I never heard about it.
Oh, you did?
No.
Oh, yeah. My third year.
I think that's wonderful.
Oh, I'll tell you what. My mom is great. She's paying my tuition.
Great.
Yep. Matter of fact, we're not having class this week, you know, because of medical. And they gave me a homework assignment. You know, they said, you know, you're going to be amongst a lot of people. Maybe they can help you because I need all the help I can get. Yeah. You know, I have a lot of difficulty. Over the years, we went, you know, why is it that we park in a driveway and we drive in a park? Why did we park in a driveway? And why does a round pizza come in a square box?
Yeah, right.
In Christmas time, the only time of the year you sit in front of a dead tree and eat candy out of your socks. And then people like go to the, how many baseball fans are there?
Oh, there's one.
Why is it that you sing that song, Take Me Out to the Ball Game, when you're already there?
Absolutely.
I have difficulty. You invest your money with who? A broker? And what a doctor does for a living is called a practice. That's strange for me.
That is.
And they say the rush hour. My goodness, you can't even, everybody's blowing the horns or bumper traffic because they call it the rush hour. Hey, and here's something. On the way home, when you leave the festival, 9 times out of 10 people, when they're in a parking lot, a stoplight or a stop sign, you look at the car next to you, they're picking their nose.
Yeah, I can relate to that.
There's something wrong with it.
I don't know. I don't know. Think nobody's wrong.
Anyway, my new assignment is only in America. Only in America do drugstores make the sick walk all the way to the back of the store to get their prescriptions, while healthy people can buy cigarettes at the front.
True.
Only in America do people order double cheeseburgers, large fries, and a Diet Coke. Only in America do banks leave both doors open and then they chain their pens to the counter.
Only in America.
Only in America do we leave cars worth thousands of dollars in the driveway and put our useless junk in the garage. Only in America do we buy hot dogs in packages of 10 and buns in packs of 8.
That makes sense.
And only in America do they have drive-up ATM machines with braille lettering.
I don't,
we have a friend that's a mortician, and you know, everybody leads a busy, hectic life. So we suggested that he do a drive-through viewing. You know, like you do at the bank, we'll have the casket setting on an angle, and then you're on your way to work. Well, I gotta go see JP, pay my respect. You drive up, you look at him in the window, and you nod your head, and then maybe you sign a name or whatever, and you go on. But he didn't buy into that.
I don't know, what do you think about it?
Okay, why? This is, ever wonder why women can't put on mascara with their mouth closed? I don't know, I don't put mascara on. Anyway, and why didn't Noah spot those two mosquitoes? They were nasty last night. I don't know. But anyway, that's probably one of the ones with KU. I'll let you know when I graduate. I want you to come with my graduate.
I'll be there with Bella.
This college shadow,
this guy died,
which he had in life,
and they had a big funeral.
But this college ride come up in about $50 hospital, since I stopped with those night checks in Florida.
This guy came in, he took $50 off his purse, and he stuck it in the car.
1 minute later, from the sweat car.
A couple minutes later, a second guy came in
on him for $6 off the sock.
He took $50 out of his pocket,
put his knife checked in his lawn,
and stuck it in the cash.
Y'all the hot students for bygone.
And when?
We don't come the third call.
And here comes the third guy.
I had a checkbook card and I had a check Ross Trigger for $150.
Yeah, he had a checkbook and he wrote on a check for $150.
I had this whole knife check.
And he stuck it in the coffin.
Put one on all the Roskin over.
And took $100 out.
Then I saw Milwaukee, I brought him cashman.
And he said, well, this guy's going, he does not need cash.
Let me tell it again so you get it the second
time. Now, you're Mr. Tantoni, Alan.
This young man went to his father.
Well, now, Tantoni, raise you was highness.
He said, Dad, you know what today is?
Hi, it's Mike at Kutztown.
Said, today is my birthday.
16 or old.
Said, I'm 16 years old.
Learner's permit.
Learner's permit. Well, Dad said, now wait a minute, not so fast here.
Don't be surprised me, I have a strong day at you and learner's permit.
Said, three things have to happen here before you get a learner's permit.
Yes, first I shoe bob and pencil sign.
Well, first your schoolwork has to improve.
No, first I sign the county pencil bob.
And then your time in church needs to improve.
From setting on the whole is a game.
And those long hair, they need to go.
Well, we long how we forget to do.
Well, he asked, how long do I have to do this?
I thought he was going by. Try moving.
He said, tell you what, 3 months.
Well, the time would have since started by, come on.
Well, 3 months went by real quickly.
I drink some Tony, I thought, Tony, we get a young dude.
Well, he went to his father and said, Dad, how am I doing?
I thought, well, my shoe lover is gone to school.
He said, well, your schoolwork, I mean, that is really good.
When I signed the county, that many shows.
He said, your time in church, he said, I'm really proud of you.
But the horse fell on the hole. What's going to go on?
But he said, you still have long hair. What's going on with that?
Well, now the guitar is in the county for so long. How many people can listen?
Well, he said, you know, when I was in church so much, he said, I read the Bible all the time.
We talked about how he did it. The Moses hung on the hole. The Samson hung on the hole. Look at who hung on the hole.
He said, well, really, in the Bible, he said, I found out that Moses had long hair. Samson had long hair, and even God himself had long hair.
God, who was the Anitike, had long hair, hence the dolphins.
And he said, you got to remember one thing, son. When they went somewhere, they had a walk. Education. Das Collins hat Frost, he won a prize for 50 years.
This guy is black and married for 50 years.
But all the Dinschdoggers and I go up to Fortstube and I'll take knives off.
Every Tuesday, you lock yourself in the bed.
When Cyfros on the deal, come on, good luck. Clarence, wish you all right.
It's black above the door, she's not. Clarence, are you all right?
Yeah, hard song, now let's be gay.
Yeah, I'm fine, let me alone.
Sweet old Spadars, with an eye come in Fortstube.
Couple days later, I can imagine you'll be right.
But the deal, Slaughter.
Lock the door.
Once I froze on the deal, come on to Glover. Clarence, you should do all right.
Why did you open the door? Not say, Clarence, are you all right?
Yeah, hold it, son. I lost me gay.
Yeah, I'm fine. Just leave me alone.
Well, they don't go see him water.
And one day, she was waiting.
Last night, I got some board shoe, please.
He went in the bathroom.
Put the deal come out.
And she opened up the door, jumping behind her.
Well, that put a Clarence on Hoku from Stool.
And there's that Clarence on the stool.
Put a fish cut, Dot, and I want a fish in silver.
Get a fishing rod, and you fish him in the bathtub.
See, that's how the essence man was fish you will do.
And she said, good heavens, Clarence, what are you doing?
I had a sword punch this net saying he'd been a fisher, though.
Clarence said, hey, I think it's plain enough, I'm fishing.
Oh, I had six hours now, I'm losing the door to the room.
She said, you know what, Clarence, it's time to call the doctor.
Yeah, well, she had phone recreation the doctor of the room.
If she gets the phone, she calls the doctor.
But this story for sale.
Here's the story, full story.
The doctor said, yeah, if this is that gun, stop.
And the doctor agreed with her. There's something wrong with him.
Yeah, well, what's you and Rye bringing?
And she said, can you bring him into the office?
Yeah, she said, he could sell all of you, yeah.
She said, yeah, that's no problem.
Yeah, well, I hope so. I book recreation, so I collect all the book.
So I got his appointment book and checked the page.
So when she and Rye bring a Friday on Friday?
And he said, how about Friday morning?
Nay, that's a good. Sell shop dollar now.
She said, no, that's not going to work.
For what snack?
And he said, but why don't Friday work?
I don't think so. Sellers of dogs my only fish puts.
Well, that happens to be the day that we clean all the fish.
See, well, that comes. You know, a lot of the dialect that we speak, one word can mean several different things. Like the word "sai" could mean a person's name, it could mean big, it could mean a verb action kind of thing. And the story goes like this. A dog is says, Pao, I know what sai.
One day this one whose name was Sai,
Asras Tumas and Hamshaya,
came out to his barn.
On Honto 9, the boot and Sai Sai wanted that dog.
He looked at the barn and he picked for him there.
The next one on him looked enough for us.
The next point the neighbor came out.
When Oz learned about Sasayan child.
And he walked down to his barn.
What don't I could look?
He looked into the barn.
Was that one the Sayan shed?
And that's what the pigs.
Yeah, well, Hutz, I cop up the new one on a Hutz, I cut the brush.
Took his hat off, scratched his head.
Now he wouldn't have the Sai, one of the size I saw. I just couldn't sigh.
And he said, I wonder if these pigs are size pigs. This can't be.
See, it's not right in English. In Dutch, he went up this side, on the side side. I just spent it side. But I guess that's why we're confused. Which?
That's Grace Stan from Cheney Glady College.
This nice little town and a nice little church.
College.
College.
I was 18, I got that one out of them of music.
But the only thing you could learn there was music.
When he went to college, was on drum clubs.
And behind the college was a graveyard.
I was 18, I got the drum order, was through the composers.
But the only people that were buried there were famous composers.
Ain't that way from the college to the college? You were a drop club somehow, no?
Well, one day, one of the students was walking across the graveyard.
When I saw Beethoven's on drop club, when they feed symphony bar spieler.
Well, he got to Beethoven's gravesite, and the Fifth Symphony was playing.
Well, now, stop now, because when he don't carry.
Well, he stopped, he listened.
Looked the microphones and wires, next to the cannon.
Looked around for microphones, wires, couldn't find any.
And I thought, he was my friend around for you, he misses his hair.
Well, he said, I gotta get my friends out here. He said, they will never believe us.
He's like, Randall, who was in it? What did the Fiat Symphony of Spiel?
Well, when his friends came out, the Fourth Symphony was playing.
But he had come started, he had this many dog cars.
Well, they stood there, they listened to this.
He took the meals of drink the professor. When I was not there, go.
Well, one of the friends said, go get the professor, get him out here. He'll never believe you.
Will the professor rise to this? When he drinks in for the spiel.
Well, when the professor came out, the Third Symphony was playing. Well, he listened to this for a little bit.
I thought there's an outshot of life, which at least that's the Lamarck is.
He said, you're all smart people, and you have no idea what's going on here.
Because when I think those little, that's what he feels, I'm speaking. Nobody feels, I'm speaking, when nobody drinks.
So now let's go back here. When you came out the first time, the Fifth Symphony was playing. When you came out the second time, the Fourth Symphony was playing. And when you came out the third time, the Third Symphony was playing.
I thought Bob came.
The professor said he's just merely decomposing.
Years ago, we all were out walking around the park,
going high, all have a cell phone.
Today, we all carry our cell
phone. How many people remember the party lines?
There we go.
Oh, there are a couple there.
I had eight on my party line.
Eight people on my party?
I was well informed. Well informed.
You do a mortician undertaker. We call him undertaker. He knew about the guy that died before they even called him. They touch people. They like all the different things like Saigon, Pixum. And we eat sausage, which is made with pigs and testes. And Ubashenko, and Kuttelfleck, pig feet, all the neat things. And we also like pickle things. We like sweet and sour. We like mustard beans. They call it the cold vegetable soup. What they really meant was chow. So we like chow too. And pickled beets and all. But I found something up at one of the stands here for my grandchildren. It's called Pickle Me Elmo.
Pickle Me Elmo.
Yeah. I never had it.
You got that there, huh?
Yeah. Pickle Me Elmo. Well, what we do, we're very fortunate to have a festival like this going on, which is preserving the Pennsylvania Dutch culture, as well as the dialect, which is spoken in the Berks County area by the Mennonites, and also the Amish speak the dialect. It's spoken not only here in Pennsylvania, but in New York, Ohio, Indiana, different parts of the nation, the dialect is still spoken very freely. Also, I'm going to let Jock tell you, he can tell you a little bit about what he does in preserving the dialect.
Well, we had schools in the area. A couple of years ago, we had six schools where we taught Pennsylvania Dutch. As of right now, we have two schools. And the reason that we're down to two schools is the teachers have to work for nothing, strictly volunteer. So I have a school that I maintain every year. We have our school on Rosewall in the township building. And I never enrolled more than 40 students. And what we do is students have to take 50% of my classes, and they have to write me a letter in the dialect at the end of the year. I also had a school at one time at a daycare center where my students were 3, 4, and 5 years old. And you talk about a memory. They had a memory that you couldn't believe. But anyway, I enjoyed teaching. I had students in my class that ranged from 8, 7, 8 to 7. I've had airline pilots, I've had professors, I've had executives from the tech faculty, who I wrote the term there, and it's a lot of fun. So if you're interested in joining the school, check over the numbers I'll pass. We have a table set up with a whiteboard and everything, and a card for you to write. Thank you.
Thanks, John. I've never asked this question, but I'm going to ask it today. How many people attended a one-room schoolhouse? There's still some people around. That's unbelievable. You tell kids that today, they said, yeah, you walk 5 miles or so for and all that. We were talking about the word no. A lot of children today, not all of them, a lot of children don't know that word and hope. Anyway, we're going to conclude our show. We got all kinds of things going on here today. As soon as we are done, we are going to do a cakewalk. Anybody know what a cakewalk is?
There you go.
Well, guess what? You'll be able to win a shoe fly pie or either funnel cake, which is homemade right here from the Virginville range. And everybody's a winner, because if you don't win one right here, you can walk over there and buy one. So if you want to partake of that, you have to make a small donation or a large donation, whatever you want, and you can be part of the cake club. But we always conclude our program with my partner here, who is living history. Jock here was a former Navy frogman. How about a round of applause? Today they are called Navy SEALs. He also was a chauffeur for Harry Truman during the war. And you'll be amazed at his age. If you do know his age, don't shout it out, because you'll spoil the fun.
39.
Yeah. How old do you think Jock is, realistically? Realistically. I can't hear what you're saying. 76.
Thank you.
85. 85, I got down to 86. 86, now 87. 87, now 88. 88, now 89, now 98, now 91. Now I'm going to get 92. 92, 92. He's going to be 93 years young this year.
The number one thing, don't.
He survives on either a beef eater gin martini, one a day, or a Manhattan. And he always told me, well, William, Manhattans are like women, or martinis. One's not enough, and two's too many. You're a great audience. Enjoy the rest of the festival. Don't leave. We've got the Martin. Celtic Martins are coming up.
Celtic Grass.
Oh, Saucony Grass is coming up. We're going to do the cakewalk, Saucony Grass, and then the Martins come up. And then there's a country auction here, and I'm not sure who's here after that. You have to look at the schedule. Next Saturday, or this coming Saturday, I should say, we're going to do a quilt auction. The top 25 quilts will be sold right here. You can take them home. And the country auction, we have items that are related to the area, just like old-time days when they had a farm sale. You can buy them and actually take those home with you. Oh, yes, and we are selling barn stores, too, on Saturday. Shia is what they're actually called. But you're a great audience. Hang on. Just stay right here. If you want to run to the bathroom, there's one there, come right back. Don't miss the upcoming music. Thank you so much.
Thank you, folks.